Good morning, students. Welcome back to chemistry class. Today, let us continue the lesson coal and petroleum. Let us see what we have learnt in the previous class. We have learnt what are natural resources. What are natural resources? The resources which we obtain from nature are called natural resources. It is classified into two types. Which are they? Inexhaustible natural resources and exhaustible natural resources. What are inexhaustible natural resources? The resources which are present in nature in unlimited quantity, and as we use also it does not get over. Such type of resources are called inexhaustible natural resources. What are the examples we learn? Sunlight, air. And what is meant by exhaustible natural resource? The resources which are present in limited quantity in nature and on human activities it will get exhausted. They are called exhaustible natural resources. What are the examples we learn? We learn minerals, wildlife, forest, coal, petroleum, natural gas. All these are examples for exhaustible natural resources. Now, among these, coal, petroleum and natural gases are also called fossil fuels. Why they are called fossil fuels? Because they are formed from the dead remains of living organisms. These dead remains of living organisms are also called fossils. So, as they are formed from fossils, they are called fossil fuels, coal, petroleum and natural gas. So, among these fossil fuels, we learnt in detail about coal in the previous class. And we learnt also the three products obtained from the coal: coke, coal tar and coal gas. What are their properties? What are their uses? All these we learnt. Today, we are going to learn another two fossil fuels, petroleum and natural gas, in detail. You know this, we are using various fuels in vehicles to run the vehicles like car, scooter, motorcycle, buses, all these we are using different types of fuels. Which are the fuels we are using? Petrol or diesel? And for cooking we are using the LPG, liquefied petroleum gas. And sometimes some people are using kerosene stoves also. Kerosene we are using. All these petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, kerosene, all these we are obtaining from petroleum. So, petroleum is a mixture of all these. So, let us learn about petroleum in detail. The word petroleum is derived from two words, petra and oleum. Petra means rock and oleum means oil. So, why this petroleum name? Because it is mined from between the rocks under the earth. We are going to learn how it is the formation of petroleum also. Okay. So, it is derived from two words, petra meaning rock and oleum meaning oil. Because it is mined from between the rocks under the earth. Now, let us see how the petroleum appears. It is a dark oily liquid. It has an unpleasant odor. As we see, we have seen already, it is a mixture of various constituents such as petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, etc. Now, let us see how this petroleum is formed. This petroleum, it was formed from organisms living in the sea. As these organisms died, their bodies settled at the bottom of the sea. When they died, they settled at the bottom of the sea and got covered with layers of sand and clay. So, when they settled down, upon them sand and clay deposited. Over millions of years, in the absence of air, high temperature and high pressure transformed the dead organisms into petroleum and natural gas. So, millions of years ago, the plants and animals which were in the sea. They died and they got settled at the bottom of the sea. Upon this, so many layers of sand and clay got deposited. So over millions of years, in the absence of air, due to high temperature and pressure, slowly this dead remains of organisms transformed into petroleum and natural gas. And how we are obtaining this? We are obtaining from the after sinking some holes to these rocks where the petroleum and oil gas deposits are there, and inserting some pipes, we are getting this petroleum. So here you can see in this diagram, there's a reservoir rock. Reservoir rock means rock that has sufficient porosity to contain accumulation of oil or gas. Here the oil or gas is accumulated. And here you can see the oil gas deposits. And from the sinking pipes, you are getting the petroleum. This is an impervious rock. Impervious rock means the rocks which will not permit oil or gas, water or gas to flow through it. You can see here the oil and gas deposits are collected over the water. What's the reason? Because they are lighter than water, or their density is less than water. The world's first oil well was drilled in Pennsylvania, USA in 1859. After 8 years, in 1867, oil was struck at Macomb in Assam. In India, oil is found in Assam, Gujarat, Mumbai High, and in the river basins of Godavari and Krishna. And here is a video which shows the formation of petroleum. You can understand it better.
Formation of petroleum. Let us study the formation of petroleum. Petroleum was formed from organisms living in the sea. It was formed by a complex process. As these organisms died, their bodies settled at the bottom of the sea and got covered with layers of sand and clay. Over millions of years, absence of air, high temperature, and high pressure transformed the dead organism into petroleum and natural gas. Petroleum layer is formed above the underground water layer, as it is lighter than water. Petroleum is a non-renewable resource and is used on a very large scale. The world's first oil well was drilled in Pennsylvania, USA, in 1859. About 8 years later, that is, in 1867, oil was found at Macomb in Assam. In India, oil is also found in Gujarat, Mumbai High, and in the basins of Godavari and Krishna.
Let us see what is meant by refining of petroleum. As I have told already, this petroleum is a mixture of so many substances like petrol, kerosene, diesel, petroleum gas, all these. So how to separate these substances from petroleum? That is called refining of petroleum. The process of separating the various constituents or fractions of petroleum is known as refining. So that is done in petroleum refineries. You can see the diagram of a refinery here. It is carried out in a petroleum refinery. So what is refining of petroleum? The process of separating the various constituents or fractions of petroleum is known as refining. Where it is done? It is done in petroleum refinery. Now let us see what are the constituents of this petroleum and their uses one by one. First one, petroleum gas in liquid form, otherwise liquefied petroleum gas or LPG You are familiar with this, where we are using this in our houses to cook food. So let us see its use. Fuel for home and industry. So one constituent we learn now, that is petroleum gas in liquid form or LPG. It is used as a fuel for home and industry. Next constituent, it is petrol. Some uses you know. So let us see the other uses also. It is used as motor fuel. You are familiar with this. Petrol is used in some light vehicles like motorcycle, scooters and cars. It is also used as aviation fuel, that means fuel for aeroplanes. Next, one more use, it is used as a solvent for dry cleaning. You know what is dry cleaning? Sometimes the grease, oil, all this, it is stuck in our dresses or clothes. By washing with water, it doesn't go. So we'll do the dry cleaning. Dry cleaning centers are there, there we'll give. So dry cleaning, water is not used for washing. Some other solvents are used. So in that, one of the constituent is petroleum. So let us see what are the petrol uses of petrol. It is used as motor fuel, aviation fuel, solvent for dry cleaning. Next, it is kerosene. Some uses you know where this kerosene is used. Long back we are using, where electricity is not there, they are using the kerosene lamps and kerosene stoves we are using. Let us see. Fuel for stoves, for lamps and for jet aircrafts. So let us see the uses of kerosene. It is used for fuel for stoves and for lamps and for jet aircrafts. Next constituent, it is diesel. Here also some uses you are familiar. Let us see the uses. It is used as a fuel for heavy motor vehicles such as trucks, tractors and buses. Heavy motor vehicles we are using diesel, light motor vehicle we are using petrol, and also in electric generators. For what generator is used? To produce the electricity. Here the mechanical energy is converted to electricity. So diesel, uses of diesel are, it is used as a fuel for heavy motor vehicles and electric generators. Next, let us see lubricating oil, another fraction of petroleum, lubricating oil, for what it is used. It is used for lubrication. That means sometimes the machine parts, due to friction, they will not work properly. So to run it smoothly, we'll apply some oils or this lubricating oil. So, to avoid the friction. So, lubricating oil is used for lubrication. Next constituent, it is paraffin wax. It is a solid residue. When we are separating the different constituents, petrol, diesel, kerosene, all these are liquid. One solid residue left over there, that is the paraffin wax. Let us see what are its uses. It is used to manufacture ointments, candles and Vaseline. So what are the uses of paraffin wax? To produce ointments, candles and Vaseline. Next constituent, it is bitumen. You are familiar with this. Last class, previous class itself we have learned. For what it is used? Coal tar we were using to surface the road. Nowadays for surfacing we are using bitumen. Let us see other uses. It is used to produce paints and road surfacing. So now we have learned the different constituents of petroleum and their uses. So here is a summary of the uses of different constituents of petroleum, and this table is given in your textbook also. Let us revise that once again. So the different constituents of petroleum are petroleum gas, petrol, kerosene, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax and bitumen. Let us see the uses. Let us revise it. Petroleum gas in liquid form or LPG. It is used as a fuel for home and industry. Next one, petrol, another constituent. It is used as a motor fuel, aviation fuel, and solvent for dry cleaning. Next constituent it is kerosene. It is used as a fuel for stoves, lamps, and for jet aircrafts. Next one, diesel. It is used as fuel for heavy motor vehicles such as tractors, trucks, etc., and also in electric generator, as a fueling electric generator. Next we learn lubricating oil, that is used for lubrication. Next constituent it is paraffin wax. It is used to make ointments, candles, and Vaseline. Next we learn bitumen. It is used to produce paints and also for road surfacing. Now, many useful substances are obtained from the petroleum and natural gas. These are called petrochemicals. Now, these petrochemicals are used in the manufacture of detergents, fibers. The previous lesson you have learned synthetic fibers and plastics, different types of fibers like polyester, nylon, acrylic. So, you have also the plastics like polythene and other plastics also. So in the previous lesson already you have learned these fibers and plastics we are obtaining from the raw material called petrochemicals. Are you remembering? So what are petrochemicals? Many useful substances are obtained from the petroleum and natural gas. They are called petrochemicals. For what it is used? It is used in the manufacture of detergents, fibers like polyester, nylon, acrylic, etc., and also for manufacture of polythene and other plastics. Now, because of this great commercial importance, so we are making so many things using the petrol. This petroleum is also called black gold. You know, gold is very precious. So this petroleum also, it is used for many purposes. It is called black gold. Now, hydrogen gas, which is obtained from the natural gas, is used in the production of fertilizer like urea. Now, what is natural gas? That is also a fossil fuel. So, it is a very important fossil fuel because it is easy to transport through pipes. It is stored under high pressure as compressed natural gas, CNG. You might have heard about CNG, like LPG we are using. CNG also, it can be stored in cylinders and used. So, what is CNG? Compressed natural gas. Now, CNG is used for power generation. It is now being used as a fuel for transport vehicles because it is less polluting. It is a cleaner fuel. What is meant by cleaner fuel? Does not cause much pollution. If you are using petrol and diesel, they are causing pollution. They will produce carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, so many gases to the atmosphere and causes air pollution. But CNG does not produce the pollution as the petrol, diesel, all these are producing. So it is considered as a cleaner fuel, less pollution. Now the great advantage of CNG is that it can be used directly for burning in homes and factories where it can be supplied through pipes. Such a network of pipeline exists in Vadodara in Gujarat and some parts of Delhi and other places. Now, natural gas is also used as a starting material for the manufacture of a number of chemicals and fertilizers. Now, India has the vast reserves of natural gas. In India, natural gas has been found in, you can see in this map, it is found in Rajasthan, in Tripura, in Maharashtra, and the river delta of Godavari and Krishna. So where this natural gas reserves in India? In Tripura, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and in the Krishna Godavari delta. You know, some natural resources are limited. That's the reason they are called fossil fuels. This fossil fuel, because it requires many years to produce from the dead organism, millions of years it will take to convert this dead organism into these fuels. Coal and petroleum are fossil fuels. It requires the dead organisms millions of years to get converted into these fuels. The known reserves of these will last only for a few hundred years. Moreover, burning of these fuels is a major cause of air pollution. Their use is also linked to global warming. That means if you are using more and more petroleum products, coal and petroleum, what is the problem? Because we know they are fossil fuels, it takes so many years to reproduce it. That means from the dead organism to produce this coal and petroleum, millions of years it will take. And if you are using more and more, what will happen? It will last only for a few hundred years. So it is not long lasting. And also, when it is burning, what will happen? It produces so many gases which causes the pollution, air pollution. And also, it leads to global warming. These are the problems if you are using the petroleum, this fossil fuels, more and more. Because it will be lasting only for a few hundred years. And when it is burned, it causes the air pollution because so many poisonous gases are produced. And also, it leads to global warming. So, we should use fossil fuels only when absolutely necessary. This will result in better environment without pollution. Okay. Then smaller risk of global warming and their availability for a longer period of time. If you are using less in quantity, it will last for a long time. So here are some tips to save, how to save petrol or diesel. This advice is given by PCRA. What is PCRA? It is the abbreviation of Petroleum Conservation Research Association. Let us see what are the tips given by this PCRA. Drive at a constant and moderate speed as far as possible. So, do not drive very fast or very slow. At a moderate speed, we have to drive to save this petrol or diesel. Another one, switch off the engine at traffic lights or at place where we have to wait. So, while when we are waiting in traffic lights, going on this engine is going on working, what will happen? Petrol or diesel, simply it will be wasting. So switch off when we are waiting in the traffic lights. Another one, ensure correct tire pressure. Then next, ensure regular maintenance of the vehicle. So these are the tips to save the petrol or diesel. What are they? Drive at a constant and moderate speed as far as possible. Switch off the engine at traffic lights or at a place where we have to wait. Another one, ensure correct tire pressure. Then ensure regular maintenance of the vehicle. So today we have learned petroleum, refining of petroleum and natural gas. In the previous class we have learned natural resources, two types of natural resources, exhaustible and inexhaustible, then fossil fuels, coal, petroleum, and natural gas. In that coal, we learned in detail the previous class. This class, we have learned petroleum and natural gas. By this, we completed this lesson. So, today's home assignment is, name the constituents of petroleum and their uses. We have learned different constituents of petroleum. So, you can write the answer in different way. First, you can name all the constituents. And you can write the uses one by one with each heading. Otherwise, you can write the table itself which is given in your textbook, each constituents and its uses. So, we have completed the explanation part of this lesson. Notes also will be completed later today and Thursday. And next week, you will have a Zoom online class for revision and also class test. For essay 1, the portions from chemistry are two lessons, synthetic fibers and plastics, and coal and petroleum. Learn these two lessons. Both the lessons are very short lessons, easy lessons. Learn properly and score good marks. Thank you, children.